The next stop is the seaside town of Hove, often described by visitors as Brighton, which is then followed with the locals' famous catchphrase, Hove, actually. Not only is England's southeast coast the birthplace of cricket, here in Hove you'll also find world-renowned cricket bat makers Newbery, where the bats are still finished by hand, and naturally these two can't resist a visit.
Oh, I'm really, really looking forward to it.
It's going to be good.
While cricket dates back to at least the year 1300, this story begins with a man called John Newbery, who learned from his father Len how to make the perfect cricket bat, and then passed those skills on to his apprentice, Tim Keeley, who now runs the show.
Hello, mate.
Hello, Phil. Yeah, how
nice
are you?
To see you?
Yeah, nice to see you.
I'm not arguing with you.
No,
that's
what
is that?
Well, this is for testing the bats. Let's come in and have a look, boys.
You're just pleased to see us.
Not only is Tim the master bat maker here, he's personally made an incredible 500,000 bats in his lifetime. Must be batty.
Now, I used to be a really bad cricketer, right? But I was told...
Same here.
No, bad batter.
Yeah.
I was told that the test or the gauge of a good bat is you count the number of grains in the face.
Yeah, generally, if cricket bats have got nice, tight grains to them, they generally perform a lot better. This is what this hammer was for in my pocket.
I thought you were right.
From the sound and the feel of them, if you pick up a cricket bat and listen to the sound of it, you listen to this.
Yeah. That's a good sound.
Beautiful sound.
That is a good sound.
Mellow.
Yeah, it is.
And this one, listen to this one. A little higher pitch, so the other one would be a better bat to use.
As for the most important question, how is a cricket bat actually made? Well, allow me. First step, saw down a willow tree. Then place in the drying kiln and wait 12 weeks. Once the willow is dry, it needs to be shaped.
I'm ready.
Speaking of which, up until the 18th century, a cricket bat used to be shaped more like a hockey stick. I know, I'm a mine of information. I can read.
Beautiful. Look at
that.
The grain on this one.
Yeah.
So that's a good stick, isn't it?
These are both beautiful sticks.
Next, it's compressed to make the timber a little tougher.
This machine here is squashing the fibres down.
Yeah.
And this gives it its performance.
After you've pressed it, what happens next?
Well, Philip, then it's time for the handle, which is a combination of manila cane and rubber, making it utterly flexible. Then it's all spliced together, requiring a little animal glue and a hammer.
And there you go, Phil. Look at that.
Ready to go.
That's ready to go. A little tacky. They'll be ready tomorrow for bat making.
Yeah.
So.
And that's where the proper work starts.
That's when the hand making comes in, yeah.
That's because the real key to the modern cricket bat is weight distribution, something John Newbery helped pioneer in the 1970s.
So we take...
Look at that.
Not ooh, sort, what that. Sort of shape you want on there, lads, but if I emphasise the shape on this cricket bat, to take some of the weight out the toe so the bat picks up better.
Yeah.
That's how we do that. And would you like to have a go, Phil?
Love to.
There you go.
Oh.
Take some weight out.
Lovely.
Mind those edges.
Yeah. Well, I used to be a silversmith, you know, so I like working with my hands. A little bit down the middle,
a little bit out the middle.
Yeah.
And if you thought it looked easy, I think Tuffers clearly demonstrates...
You need to turn the spokeshave round, Phil.
..that it isn't.
It's one of those fantastic English skills, isn't it? Like coracle making or whatever.
It's a skilled job, this one. This would take you some years to learn the whole process of cricket bat making.
So who follows you?
Well, Phil's going pretty well here. I've got my eye on him. He can come back any time.
I think you need to keep your eye on him.
I think I'm done there. Not a bad job.
I think we could have done it a little bit lighter, Phil, but this bat will suit somebody, so we're going to leave it like that.
There's someone out there with their name on it.
That's right, yeah. Good.
Perhaps someone with a wood burner.
Off we go.
There we go.